To mention one thing I need to mention, which is very, very important. We know the hadith of the Nabi alayhi salam reported in Muslim and Bukhari. When I came to this farm, I actually became quite happy. The other farm lasted also, I became happy, because then I thought to myself, at least this is what the Nabi alayhi salam wanted us to do in the akhirat zaman. So he said, Yushak and Yakuna, soon the best property, meaning the best thing a person can own, will not be gold, silver and platinum. That will become useless, because people will start fighting for it. There will be abundance of it. He said, will be what? Ghanam, sheep. Will be sheep that a person will take up to the mountains, places like this on a farm area, and then you will graze it wherever the water falls. Why, brothers? Why? It's because the next pandemic will be a food crisis, food shortages, and that is also been planned. Now they're producing, I told you last night, meat in laboratories using stem cells to grow the meat. First it took 6 weeks, now it's quite easy to produce it. So once they bring that into place, then they will start feeding you haram. Now, I couldn't understand, why did the Nabi alayhi salatu salam say sheep and mountains? What is there to do with sheep and mountains? When technology become available, then only I understood, okay, because the radiation won't be able to get you in a mountainous place. They don't put 5G and 4G towers. There's hardly reception there where I'm sleeping now, which I'm so grateful for. No messages disturbing you, no, off the grid completely. So then I understood technology won't be able to reach you. They're not going to spy on you when you live in places like this. That's number one. Number two, you have your own source of protein with you. Sheep. Sheep always there. Why? Because it teaches you forbearance in summer. You have to run behind them, hold them. From sheep, milk will come. From sheep, who will come? So the Nabi alayhi salatu salam actually told the believers, this is all that you will be needing. Some protein, something to keep you warm, and some water where you can graze your animals. So those be, if you want to invest now, the investment is not in gold and silver. The investment is where? In small holdings, in planting, in doing your own things, and providing for your family from halal sources. You can say this is far-fetched, but I'm telling you that is the next crisis that this person, Bill Gates, this shaitan, he said it openly in video, that this is one of the crises that we will be facing. Why? Because they're in control of everything. Now, we might not believe the words of the Nabi alayhi salam, or we might say, no, this won't happen now. But people like him, they believing in this. Why? Why do he believe? How do you know he believe? The largest owner of farmland in America is who? Bill Gates. He's buying up all the farms. And then stopping all the farming activities, killing of every food supply. You don't have to believe me, you can read it up. He's the largest owner of farmlands in America. Now, why would a person like that do that? Who's invested in vaccines, who's invested in almost every other sector, but now he's heavily investing in buying up the land. Because once you own the land and you decide not to grow anything anymore, then you are forcing the people to starve. If you starve the people, then you become their king. Because you can make them eat out of your hand, because you are in charge of food. That is what they are busy doing. And we're selling our farmlands. We're selling our small holdings. That is what they're doing. This is what they are busy doing. They're killing us. They're killing our economy. Another quick example I can make. They are forcing us to work from home. Why? Why would they force you to work from home? Did you ever think? Because now office space from 100 rand a square meter drop to 40 rand a square meter, which will eventually drop to 20 rand a square meter. Then the buildings will become absolutely useless, and that is when they will buy it for a steal. And when this pandemic is over in May 2025, then that same property will be worth billions again. So they're stealing it from you legally by crippling you and keeping you away from your investment, only to buy it from you for peanuts and then resell it to you afterwards. Look at the price of office space now. There's not even competition anymore, because no one wants to work in those people who is occupying office space. They don't want to pay rent also. So it's almost Maghrib, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's many, many more things to discuss. You know, it's a very, very lengthy topic, but inshallah, when time permits again one day, then we will continue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all afia and siha, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and protect us and our offspring. Brothers and sisters, we have lived a life already. Our fear and concern should be our youngsters, these children running and roaming around here. If we don't make proper decisions now, it will affect them adversely. And I'm telling you, they might not be as strong as we are. We can suffer, we fasted, we can go without food for days. for weeks also, we just need a sip of water now and then and some protein to eat. But them, because we are giving them better what we were brought up with. So they will have to pay the price for how we have looked after them. May Allah make it easy, inshallah. Mawlana Zakmal, I think it's Maghrib now. We'll continue again one day, inshallah. Khulasa. Mawlana is asking me for the khulasa. The khulasa basically of this entire, or we can summarize it in a few basic points, is number one is that the ulama, or the duty of the ulama, is to always be alert and aloof for whatever's happening in the world, and they should be ready to counter that and divert the people's attention from this life back to thawabullah, to the rewards that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept. Number two, verification of information. Use the system that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned of the story of the hoopoe bird and that of Sulaiman alayhi salam in how to verify information. Asadakta am kunta min al-kadibin. Are they speaking the truth now or are they perpetual liars? Then to be of the ahlul haq, you're going to face many, many obstacles. The first obstacle is people will cut your livelihood, they will cut your funding, they will make you a beggar and a pauper until you return and you leave whatever you've believed in to follow them again. And then number four, that the best property a person can have nowadays is a small holding or somewhere in the mountainous area with few sheep, which will be a source of protein. The preparation for the coming of Dajjal starts with the Muslimin. That you have to understand, it starts with us. The rest of the world will follow us and they will see what we will do. From there, you will be away from 5G, you will be away from surveillance, you will be away from radiation also, because they're not interested in farming areas. The infrastructure to put stuff there, it's billions and billions, they're not going to make money. I live in a small holding, I can't even get 5G there because they said no, it will take 3 to 4, 5 years because there's not a market in a farming area. So that's why I know what I'm speaking about. So basically that, inshallah, stick to the truth and always speak the truth and align yourself with the people of truth, even if that is only a few people, even if the followers are few, at least Allah has guaranteed you a good ending and a good exit from this world. Look at the life of Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah ta'ala, and look at the life of Umar bin Al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala. He spoke the truth, he stood for the truth, and he got buried as a bonus next to the two most beloved people in his life, Abu Bakr and Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and Sayyidul Qunayn Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See what you get honored in this life and definitely honored in the next life. So don't worry, you're gonna die, even if it's not of COVID-19, you're gonna die. Start preparing for